give my yes to you today. I choose.
Good morning. It's Friday, the 19th of April. And I was in a time warp yesterday. I said it was the 20th. So sorry about that. If you have your Bibles, turn to Philippians 1 verse 12. But I want you to know, brethren, that the things which happened to me have actually turned out for the furtherance of the gospel. This is Coffee with God. Paul saying here, he's writing to the church and he says, you've heard that I've been in prison. You've heard all these things that have been happening to me. I want to tell you that with the passing of time, as things have developed, I've seen that this has turned out for the furtherance of the gospel. And remember, his aim, what he's indirectly saying here, the furtherance of the gospel is what I live for. My focus has switched from that which was important to me, that which used to drive me, that which used to motivate me. Now what motivates me is I ask myself in all things, today, these meetings, these interactions with people. Yes, we discussed work. Yes, we discussed the future plans of the farm. Yes, we had a business strategic planning session. But in that, was the gospel furthered? And irrespective of what work you do, what vocation, what where you fill up life, where you do what you do, it's how you do it that makes whether what takes place in your life furthers the gospel. In other words, does it make the gospel attractive for other people? Do people see Jesus in you? And remember, like I said yesterday, we're a work in progress. In fact, verse 6, being confident of this very thing, that he who has begun a good work in you will complete it until the day of Jesus Christ. Do you judge a painting while it's still being painted? While the artist has still got the brush in his hand and he's busy painting and adding colors to the painting, do you judge it already? Or do you wait for the finished product before you can truly, fully assess? You and I are works in progress, and the Lord is busy working in us a testimony of his goodness, of his grace, of his presence. See it. See the Lord working in your life. See his fingerprints. Feel his fingerprints on your life. Feel his leading in your discussions and in your interaction with one another. And irrespective of what you're physically doing, the way you do it and how you approach it is always spiritual. It's always led by the Spirit of God who's with you in all circumstances and situations. And everything that we do should be ultimately for the furtherance of the gospel of Jesus Christ. He was extreme. Paulus, dit was ekstreem met hom. Ek meen, hy was in die tronk, hy was uit skibreek gelei, hy is aangerand, hy is met stokke geslaan, hy is gestenig, hy is deur ongelooflike ekstreem goed. En selfs daai kyk hy en hy sê, in die proses van 'n gevangene te wees, is die evangelie besig om gevorder te word deur hoe ek reageer, hoe ek, wat my gesindheid is, teenoor dit wat hulle om my doen. Hoeveel nie te meer met ons nie, daai selfe gesindheid hê. Daai ou was nou lelik met my. Hoe het ek gereageer? Het ek die evangelie gevorder, of het ek Sean en sy agenda gevorder in hoe ek gereageer het? Awesome challenge, and I trust that you're looking forward to the weekend and being able to fellowship again with fellow believers come this Lord's Day. I trust you're going to be in a church. I encourage you to not forsake the gathering together of the saints like some are want to do, even more so now as days get harder. See you, Lord willing, in a service this Sunday, and may the Lord give you a wonderful weekend. Enjoy your Friday. Yeah,